You see, when I was growing up, I grew up in a family of civil engineers. My father, my grandfathers, my uncles, my granduncles, and I had no math skills whatsoever. I didn't want anything to do with it. So by the time I got to the University of Portland, I had no idea what I was going to try to do. Therefore, I said I was a business major. My pals and I, we got a touch of selling. We decided after baseball practice, we would go to Mayflower Donut Company and we would buy something like 12 dozen Mayflower donuts, and then we would go door to door in the neighborhoods to sell them. And because we'd done that for highway, we'd done that for school things, well, why not do it for ourselves? And what we learned was when you tell them honestly that you're doing that to put yourself through school, people buy. Honesty's the best policy. I worked for a Hope Chest Item Company as a sales guy, college sales rep. I did well. In fact, I led the company nationally and shipped a product while a student at the university. So they made me a district manager. When we got married, I had left the Hope Chest Item Company, and I had just started with the life insurance company, had yet to make a sale. As a matter of fact, I really didn't have a job. I was just ready to take the life insurance exam, and Donna and I were married. So she was a trusting soul, but it worked. Several of us started a firm that dealt with nonqualified retirement plans. Our clients were Fortune 1000 companies. I do a lot of joint venture investments, a lot of it in various kinds of real estate endeavors. The people always center me, Father Bill, Father Bill's team. Everybody at the university comes from a point of ethics, credibility, and awareness. I thought they made a mistake. I mean, I don't think that there was anything particularly unusual about my career path, but I was quite honored that the university or the School of Business would think highly enough of me to honor me this way.
I went to work for a large CPA firm, started there, learned finance, learned accounting, and then I left public accounting and bought into a very small business, and that started a process of buying businesses and getting them to grow. And in between, I had some time with a large publicly owned corporation where I really saw the other side of the entrepreneurial activities and more of the professional activities. And blending that all together worked out very well for me. Ted Murphy and his wife, Ann Murphy, at that time, were very close friends of ours. And one day, we might have been on a vacation in Canada, I don't recall, he said, "You should be on the board of the University of Portland." I was very impressed with Father Tyson. He is a unique leader. I joined in 93. In 1994, he made me the chairman of the finance committee, and I've been the chairman of the finance committee ever since. This was a 100-year event for the university. Adding the 35 acres at the cost was significant for us because we'd been paying almost $1 million an acre for upland property. I do think it changed the way we think, and it gave us options to do what we wanted to do as opposed to being stuck with a very narrow path. I came into the United States as an immigrant, and I knew how difficult it was to go to college. And my folks couldn't help. We didn't have the financial wherewithal. But I wanted to give other people a better shot at a formal education, perhaps other immigrants who didn't have or don't have that kind of opportunity, but have the ability to do college work, have the ability to succeed, have ability to make major contributions. Giving is part of what living is about. It's very nice when you're recognized, but I don't think you should do whatever you decide to do for recognition. I think you should do it for great inner satisfaction. Never stop educating yourself, because that's what separates you. I think the second thing I'd tell people is, if you really want to be successful, do what you want to do. Don't do what you have to do. Get stability in your life. Good stability gives you all the other things that you need to do to have a successful career. There's an element of luck, and you have to remember that. And there is no such thing as bad luck, but for some of us, there is good luck. And though, the more prepared you are, the luckier you'll be.